everybody. Welcome to your Friday morning flow. Today we are just going to flow around our mat with all the asanas that you'll be very, very familiar with. So do take your time in each one and get in as deep as you can. Find your sustainability, your stability, and remember just to keep engaging core muscles to support you throughout and breathe. Okay, so we're going to start on our wide knee here. So as we come into the middle of the mat, we'll just pop our knees out nice and wide, pretty much as wide as the mat. Bring our big toes to touch, take our butt cheeks to rest back out on the hip, and just find that little set point. And initially, just bending the elbows and bringing the forearms one on top of the other. Far enough forward so we can gently rest the forehead onto the forearms without feeling that we're compressing the throat or pushing back on the neck. So this is a nice, just soft place here, closing the eyes. Almost feel like you're just dropping the body into the earth below you here. So just finding this all-round softness. Once you can allow the body to fully relax, let go. Park any door you don't need to carry with you into the session, and just bring your awareness to the tip of the nose. Find that flow of breath. Feel that beautiful tummy lift, rise, and expand. And because you're facing downwards, you kind of drop down into the floor and press into the inside thighs. And find that breath moving right up into the ribcage. So imagine the space between each rib stretching out wide. So remember, your ribcage is like a cage. And it can expand in all directions just to facilitate the underlying expansion of your lungs. So once you take it to the top of the breath, as you exhale, soft, slowly and steadily. Releasing any tension. Releasing any tightness that you might feel just here, right here, right now. Okay, just set your intention for your practice. Just to enjoy yourself. Enjoy the time in your life. Mindfulness of the breath. Lovely. So from here, we're just going to lift the heads off the forearms, extend the arms away fully. So we're coming into like long arms, wide feet here, forehead either rest onto the mat, or else it's just slightly hovering in between the arms, and we're drawing back into the shoulders, pressing wide. Lovely. And then as you inhale, lift the bums. We're going to scoop the hips forward. Okay. Lift the toes off the mat, keeping those toes together. Drop the inside thighs back down onto the floor. Walk the arms forward so we come into like our Sphinx position arms. And press the knees out a little bit wide if necessary. You're going to feel the inside thighs onto the floor. And then from here, just very gently drawing the toes down to the mat without lifting those inside thighs. So they're not going to come all the way smooch flat down. And they may be for some of you. But for the most of us, well, we're just feeling that little tightness kind of correspondingly into our hip flexors. Lovely. And then from here, we'll just come into a very gentle alligator, just legs. We're going to spread the legs out wide, straighten them out, and roll onto the insteps. So once you've got the full instep on the floor, if it's available for you to walk the legs in a little bit, walk the legs in a little bit. Okay. We want a whole instep to heel pressed into the floor. And then we'll inhale just a little space. So really reaching from the forearms, elbows up into the shoulders. Good. Lift the leg, bring it. Lovely. And then from here, as we drop back down, we're going to bring the legs, okay? Still as wide as the mat, but the toes on the floor, okay? Spread out those toes, soften out into the thighs. And then we're going to scoop the arms out in line with the shoulders. Tip your fingers on the floor, just in underneath the elbows. And as you inhale, float up into the wide arm, wide leg cobra. And feel that little bit openness, like chest wall lifting. Give yourself a little press up again, gaze into the toes. And then have a little look over our left shoulder. Keep breathing. Inhale to center as we exhale, a little look over center point. Slide your hands in under, press up into your table, and we'll take those heels back into our hair pose. Classic hair pose, heels lifted, I'm going to sit bones, all the limbs nicely aligned. So arms to shoulders to lift heels, ankles and toes. Good. And can adjust the feet if you feel like you're curling the toes towards one another. Get the nice super stretch into the shin, over the top of the feet, into the ankles and toes. Lovely. And then from here we're going to come classic tabletop position, all fours. Where we will do five rounds of cat-cow. So nice dip to the spine, belly drops to the floor. Tailbone reaches up, back, and head back, chest lifts. And as we exhale, rolling to curling. Notice navel chin to chest, tuck up tailbone. Okay. So whilst you're moving with your breath, with your inhale and your exhale here, have a lovely scan of the body, okay? Just checking in onto the four limbs. Okay. Sometimes we might feel that the body weight is pressing more into one arm or the other, or we're slightly tilted to one side. So scan your legs, okay? Utilizing both sides of your brain very effectively in your motor function. And then just feel that lovely fluidity through the spine as you inhale and exhale. Lovely. And then from here we'll just come back into our classic hair pose, taking those heels up, legs lifted, and scooping the arms forward. And breathe into an outside space. So that's in the shoulders, in around the armpits, and around the side of the cage. Lovely. So back into classic tabletop position. We'll take our right leg behind us. Think about the toes down rather than the open hip position and pressing into that back heel. So we've got a nice engaged leg already. Okay. If you need to take the left knee in a little bit closer for stabilization, that is fine. We're keeping it very simple today. Inhale, right leg up. Good. Exhale, curl the nose to me. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, curl it up. Inhale, flex, reach, extend, lovely. Exhale, roll and curl. Inhale, last time, lovely. Exhale to curl it, and we're going to curl the top of the left foot, lift left knee. Press back into a shortened version of our downward facing dog. So this is quite strong onto that left leg and foot. So just kind of mobilize the leg into the mat. And then inhale, we'll open the hip position on our right leg. Big inhale here. And the same thing. Exhale, squeeze it nose to knee. Inhale, reach. Exhale, nose to knee. Last time, inhale to reach. Exhaling nose to knee, we'll rock the shoulders forward, step that right foot in between the hands, drop our left heel, just float it up. Shoulder roll as we come up first, and then float it up, warrior one. So just checking the alignment of your pelvis here, feeling this lovely even spaced hips. Good, and as we exhale, we're going to float it down. As we take the hands down, either side of the foot, we're going to roll back onto the ball of our left foot. We'll scoop it back into our three-legged dog. Nice and high. Now a little bit of tricep touching, so we're going to engage the core. Right knee is going to tuck in and go to left elbow. And then we're going to float it up and back. And then it's going to come forwards to our right elbow. And then we'll look back. Doesn't matter if it comes, doesn't come all the way. Left elbow again. Reach it all the way up. Right elbow. Well done. All the way up. Straighten it up. Classic three-legged dog. So turn the toes down to the floor. Drop back onto your left knee. Good. Soften into the front of your right hip and extend left arm forwards. Good. And then we'll do little curls, elbow to knee, inhale. And when you actually curl in, you exhale, squeeze. Good. Curl and squeeze. Lovely. Last time, squeeze it in. Reaching it out, hold it for a wee minute. And And then as we put the left hand down, the right knee down, we're going to thread the needle of the right hand behind that left arm to go away through stretch and release into the shoulder. So we're going to check our feet and hips width, that our hips are over our knees. Cut the fingertips of the left hand and elevate and slide through another little bit. Just relaxing fully on that side edge. Reach up that lovely left arm and hug the baby into your right side waist width, right? So just breathe any tension. You may pull it into your shoulders out right now. Lovely. And then we're going to just press up. Come back. Head pose again. So we just every time body checking our length. And smoothing it away. Lovely. So we're back again. Classic tabletop. This time our left leg's going behind. Okay. So the pelvis is really flat. The two hip bones are parallel to the floor here. I'm going to inhale left leg. And exhale, tuck it in, nose to me. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Lovely. Last time, inhale to stretch it back. On our exhale, we're curling nose to knee, curling toe under right foot, lifting the right knee, pressing back into that right heel. So again, smooth into that right foot. And inhale, open hip position, float that lovely left leg up. Exhale, nose to knee. Inhale, extend. Exhale, nose to knee. Last time to inhale, extend. As we exhale, we're going to rock the shoulders forward. Step that left foot in between the hands, so lower right heel down. As we come up, we'll give them a shoulders a little roll. And then warrior one. Exhale as we float the hands down. We're back onto the ball of our right foot. And we're going to scoop that left leg back all the way. Three-legged dog. Lovely. Settling and balancing into our right foot. As we tuck the left knee and come into our right tricep, shoulders go forward. Inhale, float it all the way up and back. Exhale into left, lovely open thigh. Inhale, exhale to right again. Good, we'll twist and turn, getting that core working. Last time to the left. And then as we inhale to take that leg back, square it off again. We're going to drop that down into our right knee, soften onto the front of our right left hip, our right left hip, and extend our right arm forward. Right, and then it's exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, reach and press. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Last time to stretch it out. Lovely. So we place right hand down, left knee down. We're now going to thread the needle with the left arm all the way through. Find full relaxation into that shoulder. Cup the fingertips of your right hand, elevate into the shoulder, maybe sweeping the arm out. Okay. So if you have anything going on in the shoulders and you don't want to take the arm behind, just keep it with the fingertips on the floor and just elevate so you get the turn just by using your fingers. Lovely, just one more breath here. And then as we press it all the way back up, back into our classic hip. Good. From our head pose, shoulders rock forward, extend to tabletop. Curl those toes nicely and deeply underneath us. We'll bring our sit bones back towards our heels. Rip firmly with those four corners. Float the knees into the chest and gently press back into our downward facing dog. Now again, at this point, if you feel like you want to walk the legs out, absolutely fine, okay? Or else you may just choose to find the stillness and just breathe yourself into releasing those legs. So it's whatever way you feel works for you this morning. Every day is different. Remember, we want to find the tallness through the spine. Feel the deep stretch into the sacrum, into the SI joint, also into the hamstrings, the shins and the calves. Lovely. And from here we will hop, skip or jump, front of the mat, legs and feet together. Full fold. So here you can completely relax the arms. Give yourself just a little jiggle forward and back. Again, if straight legs is not something that's working at this particular moment of the day, then just let it be. Soft bend knees. Good. And then we'll soften those knees, bending deeply, round up. So really loose limp. Oh, well, head next to the grass, and to come up, and then the float of the arms up to the sky, hands to prayer. Then just feel nice and tall in your extended Tadasana. And then on our next exhale, we'll take it all the way down, full forward fold. Good. Connecting the hands somewhat to the floor, or maybe to the body part. We want to deepen into that fold. And then we'll inhale, Uddiyanasana, half forward fold. Fingertips on the floor, reversing hands on shins, if that's more available to you. So at this point, you want to feel really lifted through the core, really lifted through the pelvic floor. And as we exhale, we're going to step, jump, and walk back into our plank pose. Lovely. Exhaling for our cobra or our upward facing dog. Soften down in that pelvis. Look, exhaling into our downward facing dog. So as we start into our flow, okay, just remember, bring your mindfulness to your breath. Okay, anything feels a little bit, you know, too tough, too tight today, well then just back it off a little bit. Every day is different. Lovely. So we're going to start with our left leg. So we're going to round our right foot into the mat and inhale, foot, left leg nicely up to the sky. Good. Tucking that left knee, we're going to come into low lunge. So once you step that left foot in between the hands, shimmy away your right leg and make sure that the legs are in line with their hips, that our right leg isn't sort of scooped in behind our left leg. Draw that hip bone forward away and as we come all the way up, we're going to come into eagle arms, right over left. So from our eagle arms right over left, we'll lift the elbows up and extend forward into those forearms and get a nice deep seat. Lovely. And then maybe if we want a little back stretch. So maintaining the stability in those lower limbs. As we unravel the arms, we're going to spin our right heel down, bring our arms out, palm of the hands facing the front of the room. Now check the alignment through your left heel and right foot. And then we're going to press the arms back and push the chest all forward. And then we're going to concave and squeeze the arms together. Inhale, press and push back. Exhaling, squeezing and curling. Last time to inhale, really press it back. And then as we bring our arms to center, just come into reverse warrior. Breathing into that lovely center place. Lovely. Sit nicely and deeply into that leg. Inhaling through warrior two into elbow, onto thigh, right arm over sky. Sit into that nice and deep. Draw that chest all around so feeling that you're really flat on that back. Lovely. And then we're going to bring our left arm up, catch hold of our fingers, bring ourselves all the way up. Turn the heels and hands to the sky, straighten and parallel off that lovely left leg. Nice big inhale here. And as we exhale, a little side bend to the right. Yeah. Inhaling to centre. Exhale, side bend to the left. Good. Inhaling to centre. And as we exhale, just fold it down. Fold forward, fold. Give yourself a little rock forward, heel to toe. And all we're doing here is just melting head, neck, chest down. So whatever you want to do with the arms is entirely up to you. You just want to lengthen out. So just feel like you're really surrendering the torso, crown, the head, everything down to the floor. Okay. And then as we come up onto those tippy fingers, we're going to walk around to our right foot. Now again, set that low lunge position. Left hand or left fingertips onto left shoulder, turn it to the right. Nicely twist, just check that the right knee is staying in line with the ankle. Reach out to that right arm. Great, so we're going to use that hand to assist us into our prayer twist. So right hand onto right thigh, lift that left elbow up and over. Palm of the hand faces the sky. Draw your lovely left rib cage and then plant. Right hand on left. So as we push down with the right hand, we're turning our left rib cage through. We're softening into our right elbow, right shoulder. Good. We're pressing back to our left hip and drawing forwards to our left hip. Right. And then we'll just gently plant the hands either side of the foot. We'll step it back into our plank pose. Exhaling, knees on the mat or knees off the mat, and turning up to coming down for your cobra or your upward facing dog. Exhaling, then down to facing dog. So just breathe now into your space and give yourself a few moments just to regroup, regather. Settle on four limbs, settle on breath. Lovely. So we're grounding the left foot now, and we're going to float our right leg all the way up to the sky. Tuck that knee in, right foot comes forward for a low lunge position. So again, check your alignment here, we always keep you so stable. Good. As we inhale, as you come up, it's going to be left over right knee once. Brilliant. Elbows lift up, forearms extend. Find that nice deep stretch in your left hip flexor. Maybe you're adding a little bit. So as we unravel out our left heel spinning down, we're bringing our arms out, palms of the hands facing. Check your heel, heel, heel instep alignment. Press those arms back, open that chest wall. Exhale, squeeze and curl. Inhale, press it back. Exhale, squeeze and curl. Last time to press it back. Reverse warrior. Left hand slides down. Right arm comes up and over. Lovely, and then we'll come. Right forearm onto right thigh. Left arm comes up and over. Deepen your seat. Find the jaw through. The lift of the hip, the lift of the thigh. Lovely. And then we'll bring our right arm up, interlace the fingers, up we come. Parallel off those feet again. And this time we're just going to turn the torso round and round. And just let the hips go with it. Lovely. So this feels quite nice, quite gentle. Brilliant. And then from here, as we exhale, we're folding it down again. Okay, rock it slightly forwards and back. Really settle all four corners of the feet onto the floor. We're going to slide our hands out to our lovely big toes. So again, if you have to bend the knees to reach the toes, that is fine, okay? Because even with the bent knees, drawing the sit bones up to the sky will lengthen out those legs. So whether the knees are bent or whether the legs are straight, we're going to draw the elbows wide. Now give yourself a lovely big inhale, engaging. And as you exhale, spread out those elbows and suction and draw yourself gently in between those thighs. So again, if we're tending to round into the shoulder, the curl and end up tucking the chin and the chest, you're almost almost better to take yourself slightly forward first, and imagine you're going forwards to maybe 2 or 3 inches in front of your mat, rather than thinking about in between. So we want to get the hip flexors to be our fold point, okay, rather than the shoulders at the waist of the ribcage. Lovely, and then we'll tip on the tippy fingers. We'll walk around to our left foot. We'll send it back, find that lovely pole position, low lunge position. Right hand or fingertips on the floor. Inhale, turn it to the left. So we're now looking up at our left thumb. Press it back to our right heel. Good. A little more rotation, check your left knee is not going for a little walk to the side of the mat. And then we'll use our left hand to assist us up. So we press left hand onto the left thigh. Lift up, float that lovely right elbow over, palm the hand face to the sky. Soon as you lift, turn that lovely right rib cage and float that palm down onto the right and push down the left hand and turn to the left. Good. So try and relax the left shoulder here. Okay, keep the stability and engage in the lower limbs. Brilliant. And then we'll gently plant the hands either side. We'll step back to our plank pose. Exhaling, coming into our cobra or our facing dog. Exhaling, downward facing dog. So again, we're going to inhale, downward facing dog. Just give that bit of time out here. Maybe we just refocus. So this is the right here, right now, and our downward facing dog. Lovely, so we're coming in with our left leg again, so we'll float it up. We will step through, we're going to bring our right foot in now a little bit. So think about your warrior one. Up we come. Okay. Once we've settled the pelvis here, okay, I'm really feeling that we've got a lovely flat space across the front. Arms up, thumb tips onto the back of the neck. Press the hands firmly together and then lift the elbows up and lift the elbows back. So the back of the head is kind of pushing onto the forearms, which will increase the mobility into your shoulders. Might not necessarily be a pleasant sensation, but just breathe into it. And lovely. As we straighten that left leg, keeping the arms where they are, turn head, neck, chest, and now we're facing the side edge of the mat. Little heel toe of the left foot if you need to. Maybe a little shimmy away. Good. And then we'll take the arms out, palms of the hands facing the front of the room. And we'll just do some lateral stretches. Forward and back. Good. Lovely. Now once we come to center, okay, we're going to draw our right hip bone back, extend and really laterally stretch fully down. Windmill it down, left hand sitting inside left shin, right arm coming up to the sky. Press slightly against that left shin to pull around just a little bit. Good. And now we'll place the left hand onto that shin. And we'll bend the elbows, the forearm sits nicely onto the shin, or maybe slides down onto the inside edge. And bring our lovely right arm up and over. Pressing out the fingertips, go back into your right hip. Bring the lovely left side through. Head, neck, and length, spine. Breathe. Lovely. Now as we come all the way up, bring the hands behind the back, interlace the fingers. Squaring off now, we're going to come into hen-toed feet. So, toes are turned in, heels are turned out. And as we exhale, we'll fold it over. Interlace fingers in, locate shoulders. And again, it's nice just to rock it back and forwards. Or you can just simply stay where you're at. Lift and lengthen the
So as we roll it up, we're going to be looking at the positioning of our feet to transition now. So we're going to lift the right foot and leg and turn it to face the top of the mat. And then adjust that left foot so that your hips turn to the back of your mat now. Okay. With that right leg straight or even maybe slightly bent, we're going to come into Vajrasana. Melting down, head, neck, shoulder, chest. So if you need the knee bent, just bend the knee. Okay, it's about flowing. So don't want you really uncomfortable here. Just a little bit, maybe. Lovely. And then as we bend that knee, stabilize yourself all the way up. Press back down to your left knee. Good. And then as we release the arms, they'll literally float up. Exhale as we plant the hands, ball of your left foot, we're back into our downward facing dog first. And then we'll roll up forward into our plank pose. Exhaling either for cobra or upward facing dog. Lovely. Exhaling. Downward facing dog. So the arms probably quite fatigued from that different arm and hand positions. Just breathe. Find your space here. Lovely. So we're going to float our right leg up this time. Second side, tuck the right knee in, right foot steps in, left heel swivels down. So again, think about your two and a half to three. As you gently roll all the way up. We're going to again take the hands, tip the forearm onto the back of the neck. Press the elbows up and back. And do shimmy that right foot away and get a little bit deeper into your warrior one if you can. Active, really active by the legs. As you're really trying to press down into the foot, it will feel like you want to pull your hip back, so you go two ways. Draw the hip forward and press into that foot. Lovely. And then we'll straighten our right leg, turn head, neck, chest. So you start with the hands like this here. Heel toe the foot over if you need to. Make it a little bit wider. And then bring the arms out. So again, little stretches. Just little ones. Good. And then we'll come into that full extension. Good. And as we wimble it down, right hand is an inside right shin, maybe just below the thigh, wherever feels comfortable for you. Okay. We'll turn our eyes up to that lovely left thumb. Lift into your left hip, left thigh. Engage into the little pinky toe side of your left foot. Big toe side of your right. Right. And then from here, we're going to place the hand onto the shin. So maybe slide it to the inside, or maybe it's just resting. So we're increasing our side stretch here. So we can almost like level out our arm and our side waist to the floor. Parallel. Lift and turn another little bit. Lovely. And as we inhale, to bring ourselves all the way up, hands will come behind the back again, interlace the fingers, parallel off these feet this time, so they're straight. Lift the shoulders up, roll them back, and as we exhale, down we go. Fall forward, fold. So that's a lot with the arms. So we're going to float the torso up so it's parallel to the floor. And then turn the chest to the left and swing the arms to the right. And as we come to center, sweep it the other way. And then as we come to center, bring ourselves up. So the adjustment here to get that left foot is turning right foot in. Left foot and leg all the way around. Twist that right hip forward. So again, whatever way you feel to get that, whether you have to lift and step the foot, and then away you go. So you can bend the knee slightly, have your little fold down, and then extend where you can come fully through your straight leg. So surrender down as much as you can, smoothing abdomen and thigh. Lovely. And then we bend into the knee to come all the way up and press the hands down to the back of that great knee. And then as we release the fingers, float the arms up. Exhale to come down in our downward facing dog. First. Inhale forward into our plank pose. Exhaling with a cobra or a facing dog. And exhaling into down facing dog. Well done. So with number three flow of our trio, we'll be going to here. We're going to float left leg up. Step left foot in between the hands. We want to widen that into our low lunge position. As we come up, okay, we're going to swing our right arm behind and slide down the inside of our right leg and stretch back, whoop, with our left arm. So look at that back heel and make sure it hasn't spun down. We're lifting, we're getting a wee stretch. Good. We're going to keep the arm position and then spin that heel down. Slide it on over and up a little bit. So now we come into warrior two legs. Brilliant. As we inhale to center, classic warrior two, just taking the eye gaze along that left arm. And then we'll get a lovely long lateral stretch this time. Sweep the arm down, take the right hand to the waist. Now, if the hand doesn't come to the floor, just place the hand against the inside of the ankle bone. So don't worry about blocks, it could be fingertips, it could be supporting yourself on your leg. So wherever you're at, draw that lovely ribcage through and take that right arm up to the sky. Good, find that nice deep seated press into your left glute. And then we'll just press it back. We're going to parallel off those feet. Heel toe the feet till you're about 2.5 to 3 feet wide, or maybe 2.5. Okay. We're going to turn the toes out and just come into the squat. Give your bum a little shuffle from side to side. Lovely. Heel toe them a little bit closer, sit a little bit deeper. And we're going to cross our arms over and see can we catch hold of our lovely front ankles. Well done, lowering the bums helps. And then we'll tip the fingers on the floor. As we walk around to our right foot, okay, we're quite short in distance here, we're almost like pyramid pose. So give that right leg a little stretch back. We're gonna bend into our right knee, rock forward into our standing L. Okay. And then from here, centralize the pelvis as best you can. And bring the hands to prayer. Warrior three. Lovely. Hands come down. We'll set that left foot back. Right coming back into our downward facing dog. Inhale forward into our plank pose. Exhaling again. Could be cobra. You prefer upward facing dog. And exhaling into downward. Breathe. Give the hips a little shake again. It's a lot of work. So we're going to float right leg up. Step our right foot in. So we want the lower lunge position first. Good. Feel nice and stable as you bring yourself up. We're going to slide left arm down the inside of left leg. Reach back. So we're looking at the side of our mat. And keep those lovely arms, heels, spins down, stretch it back another little bit. And then classic warrior two, so make sure the chest wall has turned to face the side edge of your mat before you take your eye gaze along that right arm. Lovely.
Lovely, and we'll get this lovely lateral stretch. Good. Left hand to waist, slide that right arm in. So it could be tip the fingers. We could be down on the whole hand. We could be holding on to the inside ankle. In whatever way you're doing it, then sweep those ribs through. Good. And you can bring your arm up to the sky. Lovely. Activate that back leg and hip. So rather than feeling like we're rolling down, we're rolling up and back a little bit. Lovely. And then as we come over, we're going to parallel off those feet. We're going to heel tie them together again. So finding that shortened distance. Again, toes can go out or heels can go in. And we'll find that little sit. So again, give yourself a little dig or out. So once we've found this sit, okay, it's probably easier to have the feet slightly closer together. We're going to cross the arms over, and this time, holding on if we can, lift up onto the balls of your feet. Send your high gaze somewhere steady. Lovely. And then as we sink the heels down, we're walking around to our left foot. So we're liking our little pyramid pose here. Great, so we're going to come into standing bell, left leg. Good. Once we're here, really square off the hips to the floor. And up into, oops, our warrior three. Internal spiralization of your right thigh as best you can. Lovely. And then the hands come down. Foot comes back, left leg comes back downward facing dog. Inhale forward into our plank. Exhale. Just the cobra as you inhale. Lovely. And then exhaling, head goes. Lovely, just rest it out. Beautiful, so we press up onto our tabletop, cross legs over, roll over and extend the legs out in front of us. So from here, bending our right knee. Okay. Lovely. Drawing the sit bone back. Okay. Left hand's out behind us. And right arm's coming up, and we're going to come into the center point. Press the shoulder against the leg. Take the left arm behind you. And just gently twist it out to the left. So we're using the leg against the arm and the shoulder, or mainly the tricep area here. Let's go with the rotation. Lovely. Now as we bring our eye gaze center, keep the turn, okay, send your right arm towards your left toe. And then we'll sweep that arm around and we'll catch hold with our left hand and then we fold. So fully stretching out to that left heel, drawing the sit bone back. If the bind isn't available to you, then you do have a belt, just use your belt, okay? Or else you can just hold on to the piece of your clothing. Lovely. And then just bring ourselves all the way up. We'll stretch that leg away, we'll bend our left knee. Again, lift the bum cheek, slide it back. Left arm's coming up, right arm. Okay, it's just balancing here first. Nice tall spine. Pressing against, we'll sweep that right arm behind our hip. And we'll lift up out of the waist and we'll gently rotate around to the right. So every time you breathe, just feel that lovely twist and turn. Lovely, then we're going to keep the tone that we have, extend arm towards that foot first, so that we can suction up, sweep it around, reach back with our right hand, gently turn forwards and fold. So just softly, keep the action going in this right leg of foot there. Lovely, and then we'll bring it all the way up. Just extend that left leg out. The other leg's a little shake. Take the hands to the butt cheek, smooth back that lovely flesh, and bring the 2 feet in there. Okay. So from here, we're just going to clasp the hands gently around the back of the legs. So holding on with each hand. Lift the chest wall up. Come onto our tiptoes. Good. Float the feet up, lift the chest wall, and then fully extend our legs. So supported boat pose here. Now really strong legs here. Lovely, and then we can release the hands. Try not to drop down at any point. Lovely. Catching the back of the knees, bring the soles of the feet together, sliding them in. Lifting the butt cheek crown and hold it around your toes. We'll use our elbows maybe to press the thighs down if they're quite high up or else. Then nicely relaxed or drawn forward. Lifting up and out of the waist. We're going to come into a fold. So after having heated the body quite a lot, okay, it's a nice time to stretch. You can get nice deep stretches. So just closing the eyes. Okay. So, you know, if your primary goal here for yourself, because this is all your own practice, is open the hips, then maybe just focus on just the hips. Okay. If you're thinking about forward fold, okay, then remember we want a tall, straight spine. So resist the temptation to round and curve. And it is very hard. So maybe taking the fingertips out in front of you would be better for you. Lovely, and then we'll roll it up, bring two knees together, okay? Scoop into the middle of your mat, lay down top of the knees into your chest. Give the hips a little shake out from side to side. So from here, I'm going to stretch that wee spine all twice and that nice open hip position, coming into bridge pose. So we'll bring our 2 feet hips width. Lift the bum and actively smooth the lower back into the mat. Okay, we all have a natural curvature. Okay, feeling everything nicely in light. So firstly, okay, we're going to heel toe the feet together. So you've got a lovely squeeze of the inside thighs. Okay, sweep the arms away from the body, so palms and hands facing the ceiling. So as we come up into this bridge pose, I want you to try and keep the inside thighs really magnetized. So we'll tuck the tail in, press into that lower back, engage our pelvic floor, and float the hips off the mat. Now you can incrementally slide the shoulders in, but keep pressing your inside thighs together as much as you can as you press those hips up. Inside thighs, it might be shaking like nobody's business, but keep pressing, pressing, pressing. Lovely, and then gently release it down. Okay. Nice little shake out from side to side, smooth the lower back into the mat. And this time now heel toe the feet out as wide as your mat. If in doubt, slide the feet up a little bit closer to you. Okay.
And then we'll turn the toes out. And again, with nice soft arms. Again, I'm going to curl the tail, pressing the lower back into the mat, and then float the hips up to the sky. Again, we can slide the shoulder blades in underneath. So this is nice, this really stretches our hip flexors and lower back. And we can really lift and raise and open the rib cage, draw the chest wall up towards the chin. Lovely, and then we'll gently smooth and slide it in. And then we'll heel toe the feet, so they're now hip swept from here. This time bring the hands flat onto the mat. Okay. Smooth that lovely low back into the floor. And as we inhale, curl, press, float it up. Once you've got as high as you can, feel like someone's got a hold of those front hip bones. Oh, and hooking you up just that little bit more. Okay, so once they've hooked you up a little bit more, we want to broaden through the rib cage. Then we can slide the hands in underneath the back, interlace the fingers, disappear the backs of the arms, triceps onto the floor, and we can use the hands to help lift into the upper thoracic as well. So thinking about inside thighs, magnetized, hips high, broad torsos, soft necks. Lovely. And then we'll gently slide the arms away, slide it down, and just stay here for a wee minute. Done three back bends. Just want you to walk the feet out a little bit wider, and then just gently flip flop the knees from side to side. Great. So now let's just flip-flop the knees out to the right. Stay there. And just gently press that left inside thigh down to the mat a little bit more. Turn the head in the opposite direction. And then we swung it back to center, over to the left, same thing. Press right inside thigh down into the mat. Turn your head to the right. Good. And then we'll come back to center. Okay. So lifting one knee at a time into the tummy. Lovely squeeze gently in. Smooth out into the lower back. Lovely. And then from here, we'll just circle those lovely knees around the hips. Let's massaging into the sacrum. So even if you kind of want to rock it into the one spot, only if there's a little bit that feels a little bit more tender than the rest, or maybe you have new bits that feel tender, but just sweeping it around, and then we change your direction. Lovely. And then from here, just gently pop the 2 feet on the floor, slide the legs and feet away, finding the corner edge of our mat, and just let the legs completely hang out. Okay. We'll sweep the arms away from the body, smooth out over the back body, and close our eyes. So as you bring your body back into a point of stillness, do mentally scan it and make sure you feel that everything is settled just right for you. And as you mentally scan the body, you might notice there's areas of more heat, like maybe the palms of the hands, the cheeks, the tops of the feet. Okay. So be well aware of the sensations in those areas. And then bring your awareness far and wide, all the different sounds that encompass the space around you. Traffic. Sound place that resonates with you, be it the countryside or the seaside or the forest. And as you sink into that space, if you can visualize the surrounding area, making it bright and vibrant with color and sound. Transporting yourself there. Allow yourself to sit there and wait. Just basking in that feeling of true relaxation. True relaxation. Lovely. So as we gather ourselves into the rest of this lovely, beautiful day, maybe we'll bring our fingers. And put the toes a little wiggle. Start bringing some nice energy into the body. So let you stretch the arms and the head. Whatever it is that makes you feel like you're just waking up. Give yourself a lovely stretch. And gently walk the feet in again, reducing the low back into the mat, lift the knees gently into the tummy. Big squeeze, well deserved hug. And then we can gently roll up. Well done, everybody.
Namaste.
Have a fabulous weekend. I will see you.